guys, namaste and welcome once again to Dance with Deepti. Thank you so much for all the love and support you're showing our channel. As always, we try to bring something new and unique for you. So today's workout is the flow workout. It is inspired by Surya Namaskar. As we know, Surya Namaskar is a very effective full body exercise. However, it sometimes gets very difficult for beginners to follow along because of the number of variations that are there. Today we are bringing you a style of Surya Namaskar where we have broken down the steps into multiple sets and we will be repeating the sets. The benefit that you will get is that you will spend more time doing the same set again and again in a repetitive motion, which will help you make your muscles stronger and really challenge your stamina. We are doing a set of 36. So with that, I think based on the calculation, it's going to be approximately a 500 calorie workout. I hope you like it. It's not easy, but I would encourage you to do it as per your capacity. With that said, let's get started. Let me introduce the first set to you. In this set, we first bring the hands together in a namaste position. We raise our hands back in a full stretch backwards, do as per capacity. Bend down forward to 90 degrees. Bring your hands up again. We do an extra chair pose here and then bring the hands back in the namaste position. We'll do 36 rounds of this set now. For the first step, we get into the namaste position. For the round one, we back bend into a full stretch, forward bend, 90 degrees on the back. We get back up, go into the chair position, which is an extra step, and then we go back to the namaste. Round two, back bend, full stretch, forward bend, 90 degrees, go back up, chair position, and then back to namaste. Round 3, back bend, forward, back up, chair position, up again, namaste. 4, forward bend, up again, chair pose, back, namaste. 5, back bend, forward, back up, chair position, namaste. 6, back bend, forward, back up again, chair position, namaste. 7, back bend, forward, up again, chair pose, and namaste. Round 8, back bend, forward, up again, chair position, and namaste. Round 9, back bend, forward, up again, chair position, namaste. 10, back bend, forward, do as per capacity, up again, chair position, and namaste. 11, back bend, forward, 90 degrees, back up again, chair pose, and back to namaste. Round 12, back bend, forward, up again, chair pose, and namaste. Round 13, back bend, forward, up again, chair pose, and namaste. 14, back bend, forward, back up again, chair pose, and back into namaste. 15, back bend, forward, back up again, chair pose, and namaste. 16, back bend, forward, up again, chair pose, namaste. 17, back bend, forward, up again, chair pose, and namaste. 18, forward bend, up again, chair pose, and namaste. 19, back bend, forward, up again, chair pose, and namaste. 20, well done, back bend, forward pose,
back up again, chair pose and namaste. 21, back bend, forward bend, up again, chair pose and namaste. 22, back bend, forward, up again, chair pose and namaste. 23, back bend, forward, up again, chair pose, up again and namaste. Back bend 24, down, up again, chair pose and namaste. 25, back bend, forward, up again, chair pose and namaste. 26, back bend, forward, up again, chair pose and namaste. 27, back bend, forward, up again, chair pose and namaste. 28, back bend, forward, up again, chair pose and namaste. 29, back bend, forward, up again, chair pose and namaste. 30, amazing, back bend, forward, up again, chair pose and namaste. 6 more, 31, back bend, forward, up again, chair pose and namaste. 32, back bend, forward, up again, chair pose and namaste. 33, back bend, forward, up again, chair pose, back to namaste. 34, back bend, forward, up again, chair pose, namaste. 35, back bend, forward, up again, chair pose, namaste. Final, 36, back bend, forward, up again, chair pose and namaste. Well done. Let me now explain the set 2. Here we start with the plank position, put our right leg forward, rest our left leg on the ground, go back into the plank position, bring our left leg forward, rest the right leg on the ground, get a full stretch every time and go back to the plank position. We'll repeat this set 9 times because it's a difficult one, so we have to first make sure we get warmed up. Rotate your wrist. First we'll do anti-clockwise and then change over to clockwise to get enough stretch and strength. From here, we'll stretch out a little bit on the elbows. So we bring our hands back to the shoulder, folding at the elbow every single time. Repeat this a few more times just to get some strength and flexibility on your arms. This exercise puts a lot of pressure on the arms, so it really helps. Then you bend down, find a stable position of your hands and then put your right leg backwards and rest it on the ground. Stretch, look upwards, and then be prepared to get into a plank position. Stay in it for a few seconds, bring your right leg forward, rest your left leg on the ground and get a stretch. Once again, go back into the plank position, put your left leg forward, right leg on the ground and stretch. Back to plank. Put your right leg forward, left leg on the ground, stretch. Go back into the plank position, left leg forward, look up, right leg resting on the ground. Back to plank position, keep your body in line. Right leg forward, stretch again, left leg resting on the ground. Back to plank position, put your left leg forward, right leg on the ground. Again, once again, back to plank position. Put your right leg forward, left leg resting on the ground and stretch. Prepare to be in plank again. Left leg forward, right leg resting on the ground. Stretch. Back to plank position. Right leg forward, look up, left leg resting on the ground. Back to plank position. One more time, left leg forward, right leg resting on the ground, stretch. Back to plank position. Right leg forward, left leg resting on ground. Back to plank position. Left leg forward, look up, right leg resting on the ground. Back to the plank position. Right leg forward, left leg on the ground. Back to plank. One more time, left leg forward, right leg resting on the ground. Back to plank position. Right leg forward, left leg resting, and back to plank. Left leg forward, right leg resting, back to plank. Right leg forward, left leg resting, and back to plank again. This was the 9 rounds that we did. Well done. And now we will introduce you to the set 3. For set 3, we start off in a plank position one more time. Find a stable position. Then we slowly drop our knees down, drop the chest down. Raise our upper body into a cobra pose. Then switch over to the mountain pose. And we repeat the set. By dropping our knees, dropping the chest, raising up into a cobra pose, and then switching to the mountain pose. We'll do 9 rounds of this, so let's get started. First, we'll find the plank position. It's a very stable position that you can hold. Drop your knees, bend down, go into cobra pose, and slowly transition into mountain pose. Round 2, drop knees. Drop your chest, keeping the hips above, move into the cobra pose and then into the mountain pose. Round 3, drop knees, put your chest down, hips above the ground, turn into the cobra pose and once again mountain pose. 4, drop knees, chest down, cobra pose. And then once again to mountain pose. 5, drop knees again, chest on the ground, change over to cobra pose, and then the mountain pose. 6, drop knees, chest on the ground, cobra pose, and then mountain pose again. 7, drop knees, chest on the ground, cobra pose, and then transition to mountain pose. 8, drop knees, chest on the ground, slowly transition to cobra pose, and then the mountain pose. 9, drop knees, chest on the ground, slowly transition to cobra pose, and then mountain pose. And that's your set of 9 rounds. We'll take a 30-second break. And in the meanwhile, what we do next is we're going to be taking the set 2 one more time. So as you rest, make sure you're flexing out your elbows. And then we move into the set 2. We will be doing 9 rounds of the set 2, and this time we will go a little faster. So we make sure that you can keep pace with us. For that, first we find a stable position of the hands on the ground and stretch our right leg backwards. Rest it on the ground, stretch, change over to the plank position, move your right leg forward, left leg resting on the ground, get a stretch. Again, be ready for the plank position. Two leg, left leg forward, right leg resting on the ground, change to plank, right leg forward, left leg resting on the ground, again plank position, three, left leg forward, right leg resting on the ground, go back into the plank position, right leg forward, left leg resting on the ground, go back into the plank, four, left leg forward, right leg resting on the ground, back to plank, right leg forward, left leg resting on the ground, back to plank, five, left leg forward, right leg resting on the ground, back to plank, right leg forward, left leg resting on the ground, back to plank, six, left leg forward, right leg resting on the ground, back to the plank position, right leg forward, left leg resting on the ground, back to plank, seven, left leg forward, right leg resting on the ground, do as per capacity, back to plank position, right leg forward, left leg resting on the ground, back to plank position, eight, left leg forward, right leg resting on the ground, back to plank position, right leg forward, left leg resting on the ground, back to plank position, final one, nine, left leg forward, right leg resting on the ground, back to plank, and then right leg forward and left leg resting on the ground, reset to plank, and that's it. That's how we complete the round of nine. Take a little bit of breather and please do as per capacity. These are not easy, so we want to make sure that you are giving yourself a little bit of rest in between. Please keep stretching your elbows especially, because they take a lot of pressure in the repeat plank positions and transitions. And I hope you're enjoying your exercise so far. Okay, the next thing we'll do is we'll move into a set of in the set three. So once again, we start in a plank position. From the plank position, we will drop our knees down. We'll drop the chest, keeping the hips above the ground, move to the Bhujang position, which is the cobra pose, and then into the mountain pose. Two, drop knees, chest on the ground, move to Bhujang position, and back to mountain pose. Three, drop knees, slowly move the chest down, hips above the ground, move to Bhujang position, and then back to mountain pose. Four, drop knees, chest on the ground, move to cobra pose, and then back to mountain pose. Five, drop knees, chest on the ground, cobra pose, and then mountain pose. Get a good stretch here. Six, drop the knees to the ground, drop the chest down, slowly change to Bhujang position, and then once again to mountain pose. Seven, drop knees, chest on the ground, cobra pose, and then mountain pose. Eight, drop knees again, chest on the ground, cobra pose, and then mountain pose. Final nine, drop knees, chest on the ground, cobra pose, and then mountain pose once again. Get a good stretch, and that completes our nine rounds. Relax and take a quick break. We are midway in the routine and I hope you got some good rest. Now let's get prepared once again to do 9 rounds of set 2. As you remember, we'll start in a plank position. and then we will do the alternating legs. Now, one important thing to remember is that some of the people can keep the legs at 90 degrees and for some people it stretches out. There are two different ways of doing it and both are fine. Here I'm showing you a beginner friendly version of the plank, which is on the knees. Make sure your back is straight, right leg forward, stretch, and then bring the knee back into the plank position. Back should be straight, left leg forward, stretch, and back to the plank. Okay, two, right leg forward, stretch, back to plank, left leg forward, stretch, back to plank. We're going a little faster. Three, right leg forward, back to the plank, left leg forward, right leg resting on ground, back to the plank. Four, right leg forward, back to plank, left leg forward, right leg resting, back to plank. Five, right leg forward, left leg resting, back to plank, left leg forward, right leg resting, back to plank. Six, right leg forward, left leg resting, back to plank, left leg forward, right leg resting, back to plank. Seven, right leg forward, left leg resting, back to plank, left leg forward, right leg resting, and back to plank. Eight, right leg forward, left leg resting, back to plank, left leg forward, right leg resting, and back to plank. Final one, right leg forward, left leg resting, back to plank, left leg forward, right leg resting, and back to reset plank. Take a quick rest. Again, it's not easy. Please do it as per capacity. I know we all try our best, but the idea is to do it as per your body. So now we'll go into another 9 rounds of set 3. We're just preparing ourselves. We have to start in a plank position. So make sure that you always have a stable position. You can start on the knees or you can start in a regular plank position. That is easier. One, drop knees, chest on the ground, bhujang, and back to mountain position. Drop knees, chest on the ground, bhujang, and to mountain pose. Faster. Three, drop knees, chest on the ground, cobra pose, and mountain. Four, drop knees, drop the chest to the ground, cobra pose, and then mountain again. Five, drop knees, chest on the ground, bhujang, and back to mountain pose. Six, drop knees, chest on the ground, cobra pose, and then mountain pose. Seven, drop knees, chest on the ground, cobra pose, and then mountain pose. Eight, drop knees, chest on the ground, do as per capacity, cobra pose, and then mountain pose. Final, nine, drop knees, chest on the ground, cobra pose, and then mountain pose. Relax. These are tough exercises and they get tougher when you do multiple sets together. Give yourself some rest. It is very important to keep the energy and strength. The rest will really help you. We'll take a quick break here. Get yourself some water, stretch out a little bit, and then we'll get into the set 2. You've done an amazing job so far, and now we are preparing for our final rounds of set 2 and set 3. So let's again find a stable position. You can start on the knees or a full plank. That's your choice. Right leg forward, left leg resting on the ground. Stretch, back to plank position. Left leg forward, right leg resting on the ground, back to plank position. 2, right leg forward, left leg resting on the ground, back to plank position. Left leg forward, right leg resting, back to plank. 3, right leg forward and back to plank. Left leg forward and back to plank. 4, right leg forward, left leg resting, back to plank. Left leg forward, right leg resting, and back to plank. 5, right leg forward, left leg resting on the ground, back to plank. Left leg forward, right leg resting, and back to plank. 6, right leg forward, left leg resting, back to plank. Left leg forward, right leg resting, and back to plank. 7, right leg forward, left leg resting, back to plank. Left leg forward, right leg resting, back to plank. 8, right leg forward, left leg resting, back to plank. Left leg forward, right leg resting, and back to plank. 9, right leg forward, back to plank. Left leg forward, and back to plank. Rest. We'll take a quick break. Do as per capacity. If you cannot complete all the rounds, feel free to stop in between, and slowly you will build the capacity to do it end to end. Don't push yourself too hard. And with that, we prepare for set 3. Start in a plank position, drop knees, chest on the ground, bhujang, and back to the mountain pose. 2, drop knees, chest on the ground, bhujang, and mountain pose. 3, drop knees, chest on the ground, bhujang, and mountain pose. 4, drop knees, chest on the ground, bhujang, and then mountain pose. 5, drop knees, chest on the ground, up to cobra pose, mountain pose. 6, drop knees, chest on the ground, bhujang, and then mountain pose. 7, drop knees, chest on the ground, bhujang, and mountain pose. Come on. 8, drop knees, chest on the ground, bhujang, and mountain pose. Final one, drop knees, chest on the ground, bhujang, and mountain pose. Well done.
Oh. Very good, very good. My God.
And that's how you complete an entire set. A very, very good job done. These are not easy exercises, and it really burns. It's not just now, but you will feel it later as well. We slowly move into our cool off now. For the cool off, we'll start with the butterfly pose. Bring the heels closer to your body and start fluttering the knees. This will give you a very good stretch on the inner thighs and is very, very relaxing. Keep your back straight, not too arched out, just comfortable, and make sure you're able to relax yourself. The next pose, we will go into the child pose. Now for that, you can sit in Vajrasana. You can sit on your heels and then slowly move your hands forward, slide them down, and slowly rest your shoulders on the ground. Your head is between your shoulders. And now I'll count 20. Please relax. 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. I hope you were able to relax some shoulder muscles here. We now move into the cat-cow. For this, you need to keep your hands under your shoulder and your knees should be apart, the shoulder width apart. Look up as you bend your back. Look down as you arch it. Every time you look up, breathe. And then slowly exhale and arch your back. One more time, breathe. And then exhale and arch your back. Let's do it one more time, breathe. And then arch your back as you exhale. Breathe, bend the back, exhale and arch your back. One more time, breathe, bend, and exhale to arch your back once again. Breathe, exhale, and pull your stomach backwards. Well done. This helps you relax your shoulders and back completely. Now we'll do some stretches for the hands. You can lock your hands behind. And once you've locked it, you have to bring your shoulder blades together. As you bend forward, you will get an extra stretch. So make sure the shoulder blades come together and your hands are getting a very, very good stretch. Hold this position for some time and then slowly release. We need to do a little bit more for our hands, so we'll lock our hands overhead. First, you can get into a comfortable position. You can relax. Lock your hands over your head and bend sidewards. One, two, three, and then other side. One, two, three. Bend to the other side. One, two, three. The other side. One, two, three. Keep your back straight. Other side. One, two, three. And the other side. One, two, and three. You can release the hands. And now for the next one, what you want to do is place your right hand right behind you. So place it behind your back and then use your left hand to bring a twist on your back. Hold this position for some time and then release it. Now put your left hand backwards and use your right hand to get you the stretch on the back. This is a spine twist. Hold this position and then release it. Now we'll give some stretches to the wrists. So hold your right hand with your left hand and pull backwards. Hold this position for a while and get a good stretch. And then we move to the other hand. Pull the left hand with the right one. Get a good stretch on the wrist. Hold. And then slowly release it. Lock your hands together and stretch them upwards. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Relax. Now we'll move our hands forward, give a forward stretch. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, relax. With that, we come to an end to our workout session. Thank you so much for joining us. If you like what we do, subscribe to the channel, share the video with others so everyone can benefit. Thank you once again, and we'll see you once again for our next workout. Bye.
Thank you. It wasn't easy. Ready? Plank position. Drop knees one. Full drop. Bhujang.
Oh my God.